Hello friends, welcome to Trilinga Academy. Myself Shiva, faculty in general studies. I teach mainly Indian economy and polity. In this section, we are going to discuss what is the strategy to prepare general studies subject and what are the important books for core subjects of the general studies. Actually, most of the beginners of the competitive examinations such as UPSC and state civil service examinations like APPSC and TSPSC, they have a lot of doubts regarding how to prepare for core subjects of the general studies and what are the important books for those general studies subjects. So that's why I am taking this session to discuss what is the strategy to make best preparation for core subjects of the general studies and what are the important books we have to study to cover the majority portion of the general studies subjects. So actually, for both the higher level examinations and some state level examinations like the UPSC and the state level examinations like APPSC and TSPSC, here in the both the examinations, some general studies subjects are common, but we have to make our preparation differently. If you are writing the UPSC examination and while you are preparing for the state service examinations like APPSC and TSPSC. So in this video, I am going to discuss how you should make your preparation differently. So when you are preparing for higher level examinations like Group 1 of State Civil Service Examination or UPSC, and when you are preparing for the Group 2 level examinations for APPSC and TSPSC. Let us start with our first subject or one of the important subject, that is polity. Here, so when you are preparing polity for the UPSC or else state civil service examinations below group 2 examinations, from the group 2 examinations, what are the important books you have to study and how you should prepare for the polity? Under Indian polity, what we study under Indian polity, we study entire Constitution of India. Of course, it is mentioned as Indian polity, but we study here Constitution of India. So here, if you are preparing for the higher level examination in competitive exams like UPSC or Group 1 of the APPSC or TSPSC, you will get polity questions based on conceptual understanding of the Indian Constitution. And also, you get some direct questions, some static questions also. But if you are preparing for the Group 2 level examination of APPSC and TSPSC, you get polity questions directly based on static. But if it is in UPSC and Group 1 level state examinations, you will get MCQs in terms of combination questions. And the questions of the UPSC and Group 1 level preliminary examinations are framed very hard and in a complex manner. So that you should require analytical understanding and conceptual understanding to answer the preliminary examination questions of MCQs or getting under UPSC examinations. If it is state level examination, you get a directly one question and four MCQ options are given over there and you have to pick up only one MCQ as the right answer. And here we require the conceptual understanding. That's why. So while you are reading Constitution of India, that is Indian polity for UPSC, your way of study should be different from the Group 2 level examinations of APSC and TSPSC. Okay, and what are the important books to study polity for UPSC as well as Group 2 levels examinations? Here I have written a few important books. So these are the important books if you want to prepare the Indian Constitution for higher level examinations or state civil service group level and below examinations. So here the very important book, and this book is most of the aspirants will prefer this book. So that is Lakshmikant. Okay. So Lakshmikant is a common book for all aspirants who are preparing for the higher level or else some group 2 level examinations. And if you are preparing for UPSC, but you should prepare some conceptual understanding of the Indian Constitution. That's why you require to refer more number of books. Here I am suggesting what are the important books should be covered by the aspirants who are preparing for the यूपीएससी फॉर इंडियन पॉलिटी, दीज आर ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बुक इज 11th क्लास एनसीईआरटी इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एट वर्क. देर इज इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एट वर्क इन द 11th क्लास एनसीईआरटी. दैट बुक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर यूपीएससी, इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग पॉलिटी फॉर यूपीएससी. आफ्टर दैट एम लक्ष्मीकांत. सो एमली एम लक्ष्मीकांत कैन बी अंडरस्टैंडेबल बाई एनी पर्सन बिकॉज इट हैज रिटन इन सच ईजी लैंग्वेज. ओके, सो दैट्स वाई फॉर यूपीएससी प्रिलिमिनरी एग्जामिनेशन एम लक्ष्मीकांत इज मोर देन सफिशियंट. बट फॉर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अटेंड पॉलिटी फॉर मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन यू मस्ट गो थ्रू बियॉन्ड एम लक्ष्मीकांत बिकॉज इट इज रिटन अप टू द लेवल ऑफ द प्रिलिमिनरी एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द यूपीएससी. सो दैट्स वाई वंस यू कंप्लीट एम लक्ष्मीकांत यू गो फॉर द डीडी बासु. सो इट इज एनफ टू राइट मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ यूपीएससी फॉर इंडियन पॉलिटी, राइट? सो एंड आफ्टर दैट, सो फर्दर कॉन्सेप्चुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड एनालिटिकल नॉलेज रिगार्डिंग द सम नो रिफॉर्म्स शुड बी ब्रिंग इन द इंडियन पॉलिटी और कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया, यू मस्ट स्टडी सेकेंड एआरसी रिपोर्ट फर्स्ट 11th, 12th, 13th chapters. The first 11th, 12th, 13th chapters of the second ARC report are also important for Indian polity. So these are the minimum books. You must go through these books to cover Indian polity for UPSC or state level civil service examinations like Group 1 examination. So these books are enough for the Group 1 or UPSC examination for Indian polity. Okay? And if it is Group 2 examinations, so like APPSC Group 2 or TSPSC Group 2 examination, what are the books you should study for the Indian polity? M. Lakshmikant is enough. Okay, M. Lakshmikant is enough for the aspirants, those are preparing for Group 2 APPSC and Group 2 TSPSC. That is enough. So that is only enough because here you have to attend two stages of examination in Group 2 APPSC and Group 2 TSPSC. So the two stages of examination will be conducted in only objective in nature. So even you are attending the prelims mains of the Group 2, both examination you will be attending only in MCQs. So this book is enough to write Group 2 level examinations of both the Telugu states because a preliminary and mains examination of Group 2 is in MCQ in nature. Okay. And here in the polity, what we have to understand mainly, what is the objective of the Constitution of India? And what is the basic structure of the Indian Constitution? And very importantly, every time we get questions from the fundamental rights and the relations between the state and the central government and some important constitutional bodies and non-constitutional bodies. Okay. And also some important functionaries in the Indian Constitution like the Parliament and the State Legislative Assemblies and Council and executive bodies of the central government and the state governments like the President of India and at the state government governors, their powers and how they are elected. So these things are the core subject of the Indian Constitution. And most of the time we get questions from these core topics of the Indian Constitution. So that's why you should first start with the basic, that is the framing of the Indian Constitution, how the Constitution of India was written. From that also we can expect questions in the Group 2 examinations. Then how the polity is different for the UPSC and state. What you should cover in the state apart from the Constitution of India. For the both the state exams and the UPSC exam, we study same subject, polity, Constitution of India. But when you are preparing for the APPSC and TSPSC, you have to look at your state legislative assembly and your state legislative council. There is no two constitution for the state and central. We study Constitution of India under Indian polity. Then what is the difference when you come to state level examination? When you are preparing state level examination, you should cover the Constitution of India and also you should somewhat collect data from the internet regarding your state administration. That means the state legislatures. How many members in your particular state legislature, assembly and legislative council? How many districts? Okay, how many houses in your state legislature? Because some states are bicameral. Bicameral means two houses in the parliament. That is called what? Bicameral. But some states are unicameral states. So these things we have to collect the things from the internet. Otherwise, simply you can study entire Constitution of India, whether it is state civil service examinations or else UPSC, central government examination. Okay, that is only the difference in the polity. Just we have to know more information regarding our state administration, what are the bodies over there. That's it. So this is how you have to prepare Indian polity for central level examinations and the state level examinations. Okay, and next one, the next core subject of the general study, that is Indian economy. In fact, in the most of the state level civil service examinations and even in UPSC, we get number of more questions from the polity and economy. Okay, so by 2020, by today, we are getting more number of questions from the Indian economy in UPSC as well as in the state civil service examinations. The preference is giving to the economy in competitive examination has been increasing. In fact, we got 28 questions in 2019 UPSC preliminary examinations. Always you could find asking number of questions from the economy and polity. So that's why these two are very important. Of these two, polity is very simple to understand by every person. Somewhat economy is required conceptual understanding. Okay, so remember these two are the scoring subjects and you get number of questions from these two subjects in our whatever competitive examinations where the gender studies as the main syllabus. And comes to the economy, how we should make our preparation differently for the central level examination and state level. Here economy, first we should understand the Indian economy structure, the Indian economy. Whoever the people are preparing for the state service examination like APPSC and TSPSC, first you complete your preparation of Indian economy. Don't go directly for the state economy. So when you complete the Indian economy, you will automatically understand what to prepare for the state economy. Once you understand the entire Indian economy, it is very easy to you to understand by yourself what to study for state economy. Actually, even we are studying the state economy, but in the state competitive examinations, we get more questions from the Indian economy. A few questions we get from the position of the state economy. Okay, let us see what are the books we have to cover at least for central level UPSC or else state level civil service exam group 1 and group 2 level examinations. Here if you are preparing for the UPSC, you have to study at least these books. See, 11th class. There is 11th class NCERT, Indian Economic Development. That book is very important to understand the economic reforms and the state of the Indian economy at the time of independence. So that's why you should cover 11th class NCERT, Indian Economic Development. After that, there are two books in the 12th class NCERTs. There are two books in 12th class NCERTs, Micro and Macroeconomics. You can neglect microeconomy because we are not going to study microeconomy under Indian economy. We always study the macro. So macroeconomy book is very important. If you are not studying microeconomy, no problem. But there are few chapters like demand and supply, elasticity of demand, price elasticity of demand, income elasticity of demand, like that. So these few chapters are important under microeconomy. But UPSC Indian economy, we study macroeconomy. But I suggest please at least study one time these microeconomy and macroeconomy 12th class NCERTs. And later on, Shankara Ganesh is a basic book for the beginners who want to understand the basics of the Indian economy. If you understand the Shankara Ganesh, The Shankar Ganesh book is written in the basic language to understand by non-economic background students for Indian economy. So we just buy this Shankar Ganesh and understand the basic concepts of the Indian economy. Okay. And the second most important book is Ramesh Singh. Of course, this book is comprehensively covered all the topics of the Indian economy. You can keep the Ramesh Singh as a reference book. Whenever you could not find any topic of the syllabus in any books, whatever you are following, you can get that topic from the Ramesh Singh. So Ramesh Singh book is which cover all the topics required for the UPSC, but in the minimum. So, but you can prefer this Ramesh Singh also for Indian economy. And after that, for mains examinations, Mishra and Puri is one of the important and good book for the mains analytical understanding of the Indian economy. If you want to write mains and if you want to get good marks in the Indian economy for mains examination of UPSC or Group 1, you must go through Mishra and Puri. So these Ramesh Singh, Shankar Ganesh, NCERTs are helpful for the preliminary examination of Indian economy. Okay. So, but to write the main answers for the Indian economy under Group 1 and UPSC, you must go through the Mishra and Puri. So these are the important books for the Indian economy. And next comes to the state civil service examinations, APPSC and TSPSC Group 2. So what are the books you need to cover? So here we don't have any separate, Indian economy is the main important thing here. But here a little we have to concentrate on the state economy. To understand the state economy, you just follow what are the books I suggested for the Indian economy when you preparing for the APPSC Group 2 and TSPSC Group 2. So that is Shankar Ganesh and Ramesh Singh. These both are enough to study Indian economy for Group 2 level examinations. And apart from that, you have to study when you are writing your state civil service examination, you will have some part of the Indian economy syllabus from your state economy, right? So that's why if you are studying for APPSC Group 2 and you can study Telugu Academy, AP Economy by the Telugu Academy, okay? So that book you can prefer for the APPSC Group 2. So we all very well know about Telugu Academy. It is publishing books for the APPSC, TSPSC competitive examinations. Actually, the government of the respective states, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, are conducting the competitive examinations. So that's why it is better to follow what are the books publishing by those states. That's why I'm suggesting the Telugu Academy books. Okay, they are conducting the competitive examinations. Definitely we get questions from what are the books they are publishing. So that's why for AP Economy, you can study Telugu Academy, economy book for competitive examinations. This book is available earlier it is only available in Telugu, but now it is maybe available in the English also. Okay. And apart from this, socio-economic survey of the Andhra Pradesh. What is socio-economic survey? Socio-economic survey. So when we are preparing for the UPSC examinations, the budget and economic survey published by the Government of India is very, very important. So in a year, for example, recently the Government of India placed budget, and before that they used to place the economic survey. After placing budget in the parliament, within one or two months, you are going to appear for the UPSC examinations. Definitely you will get most of the questions from the recently introduced budget and economic survey. Economic survey is a snapshot to know financial position of our country. So that's why in that economic survey, you can cover most of the problems of our Indian economy and how our economy has performed in the past year. That we can study under economic survey. That's why economic survey and budget analysis, both are important. I'm not mentioned here, but economic survey of the Government of India and budget of the Government of India are also very, very important. You can expect at least 6 to 7 questions from the budget and economic survey. So in that same manner, if you are preparing for the Group 2 examinations from the AP Economy, the socio-economic survey, the central government, the Government of India is releasing economic survey regarding what happened in our country in the past year. In such same manner, state governments are releasing socio-economic survey of respect to state governments. So you collect the Telugu Academy book for the APPSC Group 2 examinations and socio-economic survey of the Andhra Pradesh government. Same like that, you have here to cover the Telangana state economy, we have the Telugu Academy book and socio-economic survey of the Telangana state. So here, so these are the common books. Okay, if you are preparing for Group 2 APPSC, for Indian economy, these two books are common and you have to add these two extra for AP economy. Like that, if you are preparing for Telangana State Public Service Commission, these books are common. Okay, so these books are common for Indian economy under Group 2 TSPSC and you have to add these two books for Telangana State Economy. So these are the books. Okay, this is how we have to, you know, cover the syllabus of Indian economy for UPSC Group 1 and Group 2 level examinations. Okay, and but in economy, in whatever the core general study subjects were there, economy is a conceptual understanding. So we need to understand the concepts of economy. Once you understand the concepts of the economy, you no need to refer and revision again and again. So you can answer every question from the economy. But you need more concentration, especially those who are non-background of the economics, they have to put more effort to understand the economy. Once you understand the concepts of economy, which is very, very easy to answer every question other than what are we have the general study subjects. Okay, and move on to the next one, history. History, general study itself is a vast subject. That's why we always suffer with what are the books to complete the whole syllabus of the general studies. We no need to complete the whole 100%, we can't also. But at least 80 to 85% of the general study subject we have to cover. So for history, so many books are there for the history and some we could find some new topics which are written by some new authors. So from for history we have multiple books. In multiple books we can get any new topics or at least we get a new line from a different books of the history. But here, what are the core books to make the preparation for UPSC history? Here, very particularly, we have to starting from the NCERT and we are not starting from the 6th to 12th class NCERT. In my opinion, you don't require to study from 6th to 12th class NCERT. I collected a very important NCERTs and these are I am suggesting. And here, R.S. Sharma, 11th class NCERT for ancient. So we know all history is divided into ancient, medieval and modern. From the prehistory, from prehistory to decline of Harshvardhana dynasty. Dynasty, we call it as a ancient history. And from the Delhi Sultanates to and end of the Mughal, the decline of the Mughal dynasty, that is 1707, we call it as the medieval history. And modern history, entry of the Europeans, means entry of the Britishers to 1947, independence of India, we call it as the modern history. So what are the books we should cover for these three, or else history? R.S. Sharma, 11th class NCERT, and Tamil Nadu, 11th class book are important for ancient history under UPSC and Group 1 examinations. Okay, and if it is medieval history, 11th class NCERT Satish Chandra is enough to cover the medieval history. And apart from that, and the modern history, we have the multiple books for the mains. So most of the UPSC in the mains examination, we get questions from the modern history. So that's why I have listed some more books here. Spectrum is preferred books by most of the aspirants because in the UPSC preliminary point of view, you can cover comprehensive data under the Spectrum. After that, there are two books by the Bipin Chandra. One is the Bipin Chandra Red Book and one is the Bipin Chandra Yellow Book. So the Bipin Chandra Yellow Book is for struggle for independence. Okay. So and the Bipin Chandra Red Book is, you know, Indian medieval history, you know, Indian modern history. And the Yellow Book is for struggle for Indian struggle for independence, Indian independence. And Bipin Chandra Red Book is for Indian modern history. So both are important in mains examination. Okay. For the UPSC preliminary and group 1 preliminary examination, you can study Spectrum and these NCRTs. So these are the important books for the history. In history, we are studying history by dividing into 3 parts: ancient, medieval, modern. How we should study according to the section of the history. In the ancient history, we need to more concentrate on the, you know, if it is prehistory, we need to concentrate on places of the prehistory, the tools used by the nomadic man or else, you know, our ancestors. And if it is, and after prehistory, slowly the kingdoms will start. When we are reading the kingdoms, the administrative structure of the kingdom, what are the different positions in the administration, like, you know, head of the military or else ministers, and what are the names with the, what are the names with that the king is calling these departments, and their culture, their socio-economic status, how the kingdom is earning revenue, and status of the people, status of particularly women, and the religion, and as well as are they minted any coins, copper coins, who issued first copper coins, gold coins, and overall the administrative structure of that kingdom, and also culture. Very importantly, under UPSC, most of the preliminary questions we are getting from the art and culture. So when you are reading a particular kingdom, you have to mainly concentrate on what is the art and culture was introduced by that kingdom. So here we have to study the history according to, you know, what kind of history it is. If it is prehistory, we have to concentrate mainly on places of the prehistory, how the nomadic, the primitive men were survived, what are the tools they used, where these tools are collected, what are the place in what are the places of these primitive places, what are the tools are available. Like this we have to study. If it is kingdoms, name of the kingdom and who initiated that kingdom, and the chronological order of the kings of that family, and their administration, and their art and culture. So these are important. These are we have to study under ancient history. If it is medieval history, also same like that ancient history, we need to concentrate on the hierarchy of the, you know, chronology order of the kings in the particular family, Delhi Sultanates, who started, their administration, and their art and culture. Okay. And it is modern history, we mainly concentrate on the struggle for independence. So who are the people, eminent people participated to get independence for India, and what are the different types of programs they were initiated to fight against the Britishers, like Gandhiji was initiated Satyagraha, non-cooperation movement, and different some other eminent leaders, they were introduced different newspapers to aware the people. They used different types of mediums to aware the people about how we should get the independence and what is the importance of getting independence. Like so many leaders participated in the Indian National Movement, the core of the Indian National Movement. In that core of the Indian National Movement, what are the contributions by different leaders along with the Gandhi? Okay, so like that, we should remember the names of all the leaders and what are the programs they were introduced in the course of the Indian National Movement, like their, whatever the newspapers they introduced, and what are the programs they introduced, what are the different types of movements they introduced, like the Home Rule Movement, Annie Besant, along with the Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So like that. So you have to understand and observe clearly how the course of Indian National Movement has been, you know, forwarded by different leaders collectively, and sometimes why these movements were discontinued and why sometimes these movements were, you know, succeeded. So these things we have to understand under modern history. For UPSC mains examination, we want the conceptual understanding of the Indian National Movement. For preliminary, static point of way, like what are the newspapers, programs, and leader names, these things we have to prepare. So that is all about the what are the important books we need to cover for the history. And if it is group 2 level state examinations like APPSC, TSPSC, so what are the books I suggested here? What are the books I suggested for Indian history? These books are enough. So the same books are also you need to study for the group 2 level examination. And in the group 2 level and the APPSC, TSPSC group 1 examination, we have AP history as additional syllabus. We have to study the Indian history and AP history as the additional syllabus. For the AP history of the group 2 level examination or group 1 examination, you have two books are available to cover the AP history, Hanumant Rao and P.R. Rao. Hanumant Rao available only in Telugu medium, but P.R. Rao available in both English medium and Telugu medium. So these two books are, these two books covered AP history of ancient, medieval and modern. So any one book you can purchase. If you are comfortable in Telugu medium, go through Hanumant Rao. If you are comfortable in Telugu or English medium, you can study P.R. Rao. So these two books cover three histories of the Andhra Pradesh, ancient, medieval, modern. And for the Indian history, what are the books I suggested? The same books you can prefer for the group 2 level examination also. And the same like Telangana, TSPSC, state level examination of group 2 and group 1 examination. For Indian history, you go through what are the books I suggested here. And for Telangana history of the state level examination of TSPSC, you have to prefer these books. Telugu Academy books were there. Telugu Academy printed history books for competitive examination books for TSPSC examinations. So you can go through the Telugu Academy book for Telangana state history, or else you have one reference book. If you don't like the Telugu Academy, you can go through V. Prakash. So that is the Telangana history. Okay, but especially to cover the Telangana movement, we have a special book, S. Raju. So S. Raju book is very famous to cover the Telangana movement and Telangana state formation. So in these three books, any book you can follow. Either you can study Telugu Academy, that is available in both English and the Telugu medium. You can study for the Telangana state history, and or else V. Prakash or S. Raju. For Indian history syllabus of the state, Telangana state service examination, you just buy these books. Okay. Here I am only discussing only to study the particular state government history, I am studying particular state history, I am suggesting these books. Okay. And next one, geography. Of course, we study the Indian geography and world geography and particular state geography. If it is UPSC, we study world geography, Indian geography. If it is state civil service examination, along with the Indian and world geography, we mainly concentrate a little bit on state geography. First, we look at what is the Indian geography books and world geography books to prepare the geography. So, geography subject is also like a conceptual understanding. So, it is also like economy, it is also concept oriented. So, everything in the nature, we can understand what happening. If you understand the concept of the geography. Here, we start from the 11th class NCERT. There are two books in the 11th class NCERT. One is Physical World Geography and one is Indian Physical Geography. So there are two books of the 11th class NCERT. These two books are important. One is relating to the world physical geography and the second one is relating to the Indian physical geography. After that, Go Chang Leung is one of the good book to study the whole climate of the world. So the Go Chang Leung also very important for the UPSC. And there are two books in the 12th NCERT for again geography, Indian People and Economy, that is one book, and Indian Human Geography, that is one book in the 12th class NCERTs. These two 12th class NCERT also important. So Indian People and Economy and Indian Human Geography. So these are the two books of the 12th NCERTs. These two are important. And there is one 8th World NCERT. 8th class World NCERT, what we can cover over there, initial formation of the earth, the latitudes, longitudes, and also some natural resources. So 8th class old NCERT, not the new NCERT, The new NCERT is simply written resource development. That is not the book I am suggesting. I am suggesting 8th class old NCERT. So these books are more than enough to cover world geography and Indian geography. Apart from that, one reference book I am suggesting here, Majid Hussain. So Majid Hussain, Indian geography. So if you study these books, you can attempt every question of the geography. And if it is a state government examination, the same books we study for the world geography and Indian geography. And for your particular state geography, I am suggesting if it is AP state government examinations, you can go through Telugu Academy AP geography, Telugu Academy regional geography of Andhra Pradesh, Telugu Academy. That is available in both English and Telugu. Okay, regional geography of Andhra Pradesh state, Telugu Academy. So you can cover the AP state geography. And if it is TSPSC, here also same book I am suggesting, Telugu Academy, regional geography of Telangana state, Telugu Academy. Okay, in the Telugu Academy, everything is covered so that we can attempt questions from these books. So that's why, and in fact, these are the books are publishing by the state governments relating to that state government geography. So that's why it is better to go through these books are very important. Okay, and in geography, we can expect questions from the world geography and we can expect questions from the Indian geography, like the climate and interior of the earth and volcanoes and earthquakes, and the planetary winds and some important islands, their locations and why they are submerging in the oceans and how the climate of our planet is changing. So these all things we have to cover under the geography. And movement of the ocean water, how the ocean water is moving, what are the warm currents, cold currents, like this we cover the Indian geography. And these are the exactly important books. Other than these books, you don't need to study any other. Okay, and it is very important to buy Oxford Atlas map book. So Oxford Atlas also you have to buy along with these books. So when you are reading the geography, you keep always carry Oxford Atlas and look at the map and you study. When you are studying geography by looking the map, you will understand in the better manner. Okay, and next move on to the environment and ecology. So there is no problem, environment ecology. So for the both the state government examinations and the UPSC examinations, environment and ecology is a same. So here we have the very good book for the environment and ecology. Most of the UPSC aspirants prefer this one. Shankar IAS is there. You can study Shankar IAS or else you can go through Dr. Kullar. So both are important for the environment and ecology. Okay, and apart from that, ICSE 9th and 10th class books. ICSE 9th and 10th class books and 11th NCERT. So 11th NCERT, not 11th NCERT, ICSE 9th and 10th for the environment and ecology. And here in the environment ecology, we need to concentrate mainly on the current affairs also. And the last one is disaster management. So for disaster management, 11th class NCERT. So for the disaster management, 11th class NCERT and some other, some reference books were there to cover the disaster management. In the disaster management, we have to understand mainly what are the forces are there in India who will react immediately when there is a particular, to manage a particular disaster. So when the disasters were occurring, who are the forces? What are the central government, state government forces to immediately involve to prevent the disaster or else to save the people from the disaster? So we have to study different forces engaging in the disaster management. What are the different kinds of approaches to manage the disaster and what are the different types of disasters, like the natural disaster, man-made disasters, chemical disasters, like this. Okay, so that is how we have to study the disaster management for the UPSC. And here I am suggesting the 11th class NCERT. You can purchase any reference book in the market. If it is the state government examinations for disaster management, we have the Telugu Academy book again. There is a Telugu Academy book for the APPSC. It is available in the both English and Telugu for the disaster management. So in the state government of state and Telangana state government TSPSC examinations also there is Telugu Academy book. Okay, if you want, or else you can go through the NCERT and you just collect the data from the internet. What are the different central forces will participate to manage the disasters? Okay, first responsive forces, second responsive forces, like that. So for the state level examination, if you are Telugu medium candidate, you can study the Telugu Academy book for the disaster management. It is available in both English and Telugu. For the Telangana state level examination also, you can prefer Telugu Academy books for the disaster management. So these are the core subjects of the general studies. So in all the competitive examination where the general study as the main subjects, so these are the common subjects. These are the common subjects for the state level examinations and the central government examination. In which examination we have general study subject as the main syllabus. So these are the books we have to study to cover these core subject of the general studies. According to which competitive examination you are preferring, maybe there are some additional syllabus under state government or else in the central government. But the common subject are these. So these are the common subject. And the remaining syllabus will change according to what kind of examination you are writing. But what are the examinations where the general study has main subject? These are the common subject and these are the books you need to prefer to cover the comprehensive syllabus of these core general study subjects. And this is how you have to prepare. You make your preparation differently from central government examination to state government examination. In our state government examination, we cover some additional syllabus relating to our state government. But what I suggest, you first cover central syllabus. If you are preparing for state level APPSC or TSPSC, you first complete the syllabus of the Indian geography, Indian polity, Indian history and Indian geography. You cover the syllabus of the central government and automatically you will get understand what to study for the state. In the state government examination, something extra added relating to the state government. If it is geography, what is the state geography of the Andhra Pradesh? It is not very comprehensive in terms of state syllabus. So we just concentrate on the, for example, if it is geography, what are the resources in a particular state government, how these resources are mobilizing, what are the different industries, how the state government is getting revenue, what is the socio-economic status of the people of that particular state government. So like this we get the questions only, that's it. So other than geography is same for the both and the state. So when it is comes to your state government examination, we mainly concentrate particularly on your state government physiography, divisions of your state government, different types of lands and soils in your state government, different types of crops growing in your state government, and different rivers flowing in your state government, through your state government, through your state. So these we need to concentrate in terms of the state government examination. Otherwise, these both, all the syllabus is same, but why we are making, we have to make our preparation differently according to the standard of the examination. Here it is group 2 level examination. It is very easy, direct questions we get from the static portion of the general studies syllabus. But in the UPSC and group 1 state civil service examination, we require conceptual and analytical understanding. So I hope this video helpful for the beginners who are making their preparation for the first time for the UPSC and state government examinations. If you have any doubts further, of course there are some extra syllabus is there in UPSC and the state government examination, but here I thought what are the core subjects of the common subjects of the state government civil service examinations and UPSC examination. If you have any doubt, you just comment below, I will give reply. Thank you.